My dad and I start the month off with the El Mariachi trilogy, directed by Robert Rodriguez. What's really special about the first installment, El Mariachi, is that it was made with a really small budget of only $7,000. $7,000 is really nothing, especially if you think about how when a movie has a budget of less than $1 million, it's considered a small budget. So yeah, movies can easily go up to $200-300 million. So sometimes you didn't notice that the movie had a small budget, but the movie was still really enjoyable because it had a great story and great characters. And for me, it was very inspiring to see what all can be done with such a small budget. The next day, we then watched the second part, Desperado, which personally, out of the three, is my favorite one. For this movie, they now had a budget of $7 million because, yeah, the first movie had such a big success. And what also changed is they casted Antonio Banderas as the El Mariachi, the protagonist. And since Desperado was so successful, the third installment, Once Upon a Time in Mexico, received a budget of $29 million. So 4 times of that they received for the second film. Personally, I like this one the least. You know, the story just kind of got too complicated. There were multiple subplots that didn't really matter to me or most of the people who saw this movie. And yeah, just felt a bit too overdone. But yeah, it was still fun to watch. You know, the characters were great. And yeah, I really love this trilogy. I'm really glad my Uncle Jeff, recommended this to me to check it out because he knew I'm interested in making movies. And yeah, that it'd be inspiring to see what all can be done with a small budget of $7,000. Samuel L. Jackson and Matthew McConaughey, a true Texan, are some of my favorite actors, and they both starred in A Time to Kill. The main part of the movie plays in court, but because the dialogue is written very well and interesting, there was suspense throughout the entire movie, and yeah, it was a great drama. Arrival is one of those movies I've been wanting to see for a really long time now because I heard a lot of great things about it. It won, I believe, multiple Academy Awards, at least nominated. And yeah, one night I just decided to sit down and watch it since it's on Netflix. I really loved this movie. It was really great. The story was awesome. And I loved how as the movie progressed, you started to connect the dots and understood more and more as the movie kept on going. That's really all I want to say about it. The performances were really great, especially Amy Adams, who is one of my favorite actresses. And yeah, I highly recommend to check this movie out. It will definitely be in my top three recommendations at the end. We then continued with the Alfred Hitchcock collection, and Vertigo is considered by a lot of people one of the best movies of all time. And I have to agree, it was a really great, great movie with a lot of suspense by the king of suspense. Just like in the other Hitchcock movies I've seen, I really love how he puts the audience and the protagonist in the same situation where we all don't really know what is going on exactly or why these things are happening. So yeah, that creates a lot of suspense, and I really love this movie. During September, I was working on the masterclass by Spike Lee about independent filmmaking, and so I decided to watch his debut movie, She's Gotta Have It. The movie was filmed in black and white, except for one scene, and it tells the story of a young lady and the relationship she has with three men. Spike Lee plays one of those men, and yeah, I just really love watching him play characters that he wrote in his own movie that he directed. That's yeah, he's really a funny guy. Yeah, I will actually upload my masterclass video sometime next week. And yeah, I'm really starting to love his movies more and more. And hopefully I'll get to see some more in the future. It's honestly been a while since I've last seen a spaghetti Western. So I was really glad to watch My Name is Nobody. The idea for this movie came from the legendary Sergio Leone. The movie is definitely nothing compared to some of his other masterpieces, but it was very entertaining and I had a great time watching it. What I loved most about the movie was the score. It was composed by the legendary Ennio Morricone, who just recently passed away. Once I was scrolling through Apple TV and I came across the movie Loose, which at the time was a free rental. So obviously I downloaded it and had 30 days to watch it. And then it was about to expire in about 24 hours. And somehow my dad and I decided to watch the trailer, which by then we hadn't seen yet. And after watching the trailer, we were like, okay, this movie looks really interesting and special. We gotta watch this tonight. It was definitely a very special movie and I really liked it. Certain elements of it reminded me of First Reformed, gave me kind of a similar vibe at the end. And I loved how there was a lot of suspense in it and you never know how and if things were gonna escalate. The Big Lebowski is a classic movie for me and one of the best comedies of all time. John Turturro's role as Jesus Quintana is also very iconic, and so I was really excited when I first heard that the Jesus roles was announced. The ratings for this movie were honestly really bad, and yeah, it took me until now to finally spend a dollar to rent the movie, but it was actually better than I thought it would be. The movie doesn't have any big plot that it follows. You're just kind of there hanging out with the characters on screen. But because his characters and the others are really fun to watch, there were some funny moments throughout the movie. At the end of the movie, it said that the story was inspired by the movie Les Valseuses, a French movie. And yeah, I definitely want to check that out sometime soon. Lately, I've been hearing Charlie Kaufman's name a lot. He just recently released a movie on Netflix. And because I've heard a lot about The Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, and that it won the best screenplay back in the early 2000s, so I decided to watch that movie. He really deserved the Academy Award, and I loved how the movie told the story about this unlikely couple in a non-linear order. I also heard a lot of great things about Jack Nicholson's Oscar-winning performance in One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. So for the last evening of September, my dad and I watched that movie. It was a really great performance that made me feel a lot of different emotions. And yeah, the story takes place in a mental hospital and Jack Nicholson's characters, you know, he kind of messes around with the rules there and also changes the patients inside the hospital. The other patients were also played really well, and it was really fun to see Danny DeVito at a young age. I wouldn't have noticed him if my dad didn't mention that he was in this movie. So these are the movies that I watched in September 2020. Now to this month's movie recommendations. First off, I'd recommend Arrival. It's a different type of science fiction movie, and yeah, what I also really liked about it was about communication and universal interactions. Then I'd recommend to watch Vertigo, directed by the great Alfred Hitchcock. Yeah, as said before, it's very suspenseful and a great movie. And lastly, I'd recommend to check out One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. It's also a great movie with memorable performances, and it will definitely make you laugh as well. So yeah, let me know if y'all have seen any of these movies and how y'all like them, and until next month.